Hello friends, and welcome to a lecture on water and life. The main objectives of today's lecture are to understand the polarity of water molecules, an overview of properties of water, and a general idea of ionization of water. Let me first of all begin by highlighting the importance of water. Water is one of the most unique molecules known to man and also one of the most important to biological systems. Not only does water exist in nature, in all three states of matter, solid, liquid, gas, it also covers 75% of the earth and composes roughly 78% of the human body. Moving on, let's now discuss it in detail. Pure water is colorless, odorless, and tasteless, and so common that you probably never think about how unique it is and how essential to life. Most plants and animals contain more than 60% of water by volume. Water is also an important vehicle for removing body waste products. As part of the digestive juices, it helps to change consumed food into nutrients that body can use. Within the bloodstream, it also helps to carry those nutrients to the body cell in need and carry away cellular waste products. Waste products are then excreted from the body. Most unwanted substances in the body can be removed from the body via the urine. Water helps to form the lubricants found in the joints of the body. It is also the basis for saliva, bile, and amniotic fluid, the important shock-absorbing fluid which surrounds an unborn fetus. Water is involved in all the body processes. Water is an efficient heat conductor and serves to maintain the uniform body temperature, essential for health. As a protector of internal organs, water is indispensable. It serves as a cushion and prevents the transmission of shock from the outside. It also serves as a nature's solvent for many chemical compounds and is the medium for many chemical reactions to occur. Now, let's discuss water as a polar molecule. Each molecule of water consists of one atom of oxygen and two atoms of hydrogen. The oxygen atom in a water molecule attracts negatively charged electrons more strongly than the hydrogen atoms do. As a result, the oxygen atom has a slightly negative charge and the hydrogen atom has a slightly positive charge. A difference in the electrical charge between different parts of the same molecule is called polarity, making water a polar molecule. Each hydrogen atom of a water molecule shares an electron pair with the central oxygen atom. The geometry of the molecule is dictated by the shapes of the outer electron orbitals of the oxygen atom, which are similar to the sp3 bonding orbitals of carbon. These orbitals describe a rough tetrahedron with a hydrogen atom at each of the two corners and unshared electron pairs at the other two corners. The sharing of electron between hydrogen and oxygen is therefore unequal. The electrons are more often in the vicinity of the oxygen atom than of the hydrogen. The result of this unequal sharing is two electron dipoles in the water molecule, one along each of the HOO bonds. Each hydrogen bears a partial positive charge and the oxygen atom bears a partial negative charge equal to the sum of two partial positives. As a result, there is an electrostatic attraction between the oxygen atom of one water molecule and the hydrogen of another, called a hydrogen bond. The polarity of water is responsible for effectively dissolving other polar molecules. such as sugars and ionic compounds such as salt. Ionic compounds dissolve in water to form ions. This is important to remember because most of the biological reactions to occur, the reactants must be dissolved in water. Coming on to my next objective, which is properties of water. First, I will discuss polarity. Polarity simply means that the molecule has both positive and negatively charged ends. More important, the polarity of water is responsible for effectively dissolving other polar molecules such as sugars and ionic compounds such as salt. Ionic compounds dissolve in water to form ions. Because water is able to dissolve so many substances, it is known as universal solvent. Substances that cannot be dissolved by water, such as oils, are called fat soluble and are nonpolar. Non-ionic compounds that are strongly covalently bonded, insoluble substances make excellent container of water, such as cell membranes and cell walls. Next comes hydrogen bonding. When water molecules align with each other, a weak bond is established between the negatively charged oxygen atom of one water molecule and the positively charged hydrogen atoms of a neighboring water molecule. The weak bond that often forms between hydrogen atom and neighboring atoms is the hydrogen bond. Next is cohesion. Because of extensive hydrogen bonding in water, the molecules tend to stick each other in a regular pattern. This phenomena called cohesion is easily observed as you carefully overfill a glass with water and observe the water molecules holding together above the rim until gravity overtakes the hydrogen bonding and the water molecules spill down the sides of the glass. Now, specific heat. Water has a high specific heat index. It absorbs a lot of heat before it begins to get hot. This is why water is valuable to industries and in your car radiators as a coolant. Now, it is the heat of vaporization. Water has a high heat of vaporization. Water absorbs heat as it changes from liquid to gas. The human body can dissipate excess of heat by evaporation of its sweat. Now, boiling and freezing points. Pure water at sea level boils at 100 degrees centigrade and freezes at 0 degrees centigrade. But extra energy is needed to push the water molecules into air. This is called latent heat. The heat required to change water from one phase to another. At higher elevations, lower atmospheric pressure, water's boiling temperature decreases. This is why it takes longer to boil an egg at higher altitudes. The temperature does not get high enough to cook the egg properly. If a substance is dissolved in water, then the freezing point is lowered. That is why we spread salt on streets in winter to prevent ice formation. Energy is lost when water freezes. A great deal of heat is released into the environment when liquid water changes to ice. It is lost when the high energy phase of liquid water moves to the low energy phase of ice. Nights when ice freezes often feel warmer than the nights when ice melts. Coming on to the next is the water density. Water is most dense at 4 degrees centigrade and then begins to expand again, becoming less dense as the temperature decreases further. This expansion occurs because its hydrogen bonds become more rigid and ordered. As a result, frozen water, ice, floats upon the denser, colder water. The expansion of water takes place even before it actually freezes. This explains why a pond freezes from surface down rather than the bottom up. As water temperature drops, the colder water, 0 to 4 degrees centigrade, where it is less dense, rises to the pond surface. It freezes to form a lid of ice. This ice insulates the water below from the wintry chill so that it is less likely to freeze. Organisms that inhabit the pond are able to survive the frigid winter below the icy surface. Coming on to the next is the solid expansion. For most substances, solids are denser than liquids, but the special property of water makes it less denser as solid. Ice floats on water. Strong hydrogen bonds formed at freezing 0 degree centigrade lock water molecules away from each other. When ice melts, the structure collapses and molecules move close together. Liquid water at 4 degree centigrade is about 9% denser than ice. This property plays an important role in lake and ocean ecosystems. Water molecules have a tendency to ionize. They disassociate into ions, charged particles, hydrogen ion H positive and hydroxide ion OH negative. In pure water, a very small number of water molecules form ions in this way. The tendency of water to disassociate is balanced by the tendency of hydrogen ions and hydroxide ions to reunite to form water. A neutral solution contains an equal number of hydroxide ions and hydrogen ions. A solution with a greater concentration of hydrogen ions H positive is said to be acidic. A solution with greater concentration of hydroxide ions OH negative is said to be alkaline or basic. Having understood the concept of properties of water, let's now talk about ionization of water. The self-ionization of water is an ionization reaction in pure water or an aqueous solution, in which a water molecule H2O deprotonates, loses the nucleus of one of its hydrogen atom to become hydroxide ion OH negative. The hydrogen nucleus H positive immediately protonates another water molecule to form hydronium H3O positive. It is an example of autoprotolysis and exemplifies the amphoteric nature of water. The ionization of water can be represented as H2O gives H positive plus OH negative. The law of mass action can be applied defining the equilibrium constant for the reversible ionization of water, KEQ. KEQ is equal to H positive OH negative divided by H2O. The concentration of each moiety is expressed in moles per liter m. The degree of ionization of water is very low at any given time. The amount of hydronium ions and hydroxide ions present in water is extremely small, and consequently the concentration of undissociated water molecules is virtually unchanged by this minute ionization and may be considered a constant. Let's switch over to the concept of buffer. A buffer solution is an aqueous solution consisting of a mixture of weak acid and its conjugate base, or vice versa. Its pH changes very little when a small or moderate amount of strong acid or base is added to it, and thus it is used to prevent changes in the pH of solution. Buffer solutions are used as a means of keeping pH at a nearly constant value in a wide variety of chemical applications. Many life forms thrive only in a relatively small pH range, so they utilize a buffer solution to maintain a constant pH. Each acid has a tendency to lose its proton in aqueous solution. The stronger the acid, the greater the tendency. The titration curve of a weak acid and its conjugate base shows that these compounds can be used to buffer solutions. Buffering is a consequence of two reversible reactions taking place simultaneously and reaching the equilibrium points as governed by their equilibrium constants Kw and Ka. When strong acid is added to an equilibrium mixture of weak acid and its conjugate base, the equilibrium is shifted to the left in accordance with the Lee-Chatler's principle. Because of this, the hydrogen ion concentration increases by less than the amount expected for the quantity of strong acid added. Similarly, if the strong alkali is added to the mixture of hydrogen ion, concentration decreases by less than the amount expected for the quantity of alkali added. The effect is illustrated by the simulated titration of a weak acid with the pKa is equal to 4.7. The pH changes relatively slowly in the buffer region. pH is equal to pKa plus minus 1. Centered at pH is equal to 4.7, where HA is equal to A negative. The hydrogen ion concentration decreases by less than the amount expected because most of the added hydroxide ion is consumed in the reaction. Dear students, this was all for today's program. Thank you and goodbye.